गुड मॉर्निंग ग्रेट 10 वेलकम बैक टू बीबीबीएन ऑनलाइन क्लासेस वी वर इन चैप्टर नंबर 8 ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक रेशियोस फन अंडरस्टैंडिंग ट्रिग्नोमेट्री फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ ट्रिग्नोमेट्री व्हाट एवर यू कैन कॉल इट द टॉपिक दैट वी वर डिस्कसिंग वाज ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक रेशियोस ऑफ स्पेसिफिक एंगल्स पर्टिकुलर एंगल्स इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैड डिस्कस्ड वी हैव डिराइव्ड द ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक रेशियोस फॉर एंगल्स 30 डिग्रीज 45 degrees and 60 degrees, right? Today we'll discuss about the angle when it becomes 0 degree or 90 degrees. So here I have theta. If this theta tends to become 0 degree, I'm not saying theta equal to 0. See, that is practically not possible. If theta becomes 0, this trigonometry, this point A has to coincide with point B. You can't form a triangle. But I'm saying if theta tends to become zero, what happens if theta has to become zero? This value has to reduce. Point A has to slide down gradually. As point A comes down, the magnitude of theta decreases. Whatever it is, suppose theta equal to 60 degrees here. So as this point A slides down along AB, the theta reduces, value of this reduces, it comes down from 60 degrees. So point A has to coincide with point B so that theta becomes zero. So if theta tends to become zero, then this AB, length of AB, tends to become zero units. Point A coincides with point B. So the effect of this theta becoming 0 is point A has to slide down to B, it will coincide with point B. In that case, length of line segment AB will tend to become 0 units and this AC will be equal to BC because point A has coincided with point B. So AC will be equal to BC because point A comes with point B. So what will be the effect? Sine theta, that is sine 0 degrees. We know sine is perpendicular upon hypotenuse, that is AB upon AC. So what happens when theta tends to become 0 degrees, AB tends to become 0 units. So it is 0 upon AC, that is 0. So sine ratio of 0 degrees is equal to 0. What happens with cos? Cos theta, that is cos of 0 degrees. Cos is base upon hypotenuse, that is BC upon AC. What happens when theta tends to become 0 degrees? AC will be equal to BC, so I can replace BC by AC or I can replace AC by BC. So this is AC upon AC, which is 1. So cos ratio of 0 degrees is equal to 1. Now tan theta. Tan 0 degrees. What is tan ratio? Perpendicular upon base. So according to this triangle, it will be AB upon BC. Now, point AB tends to become 0 units as theta tends to become 0 degrees. So AB will be 0. 0 upon BC. How much? 0. 0 divided by any real number other than 0. So BC has got some length. Some length, it has a length. It has magnitude. So 0 divided by some real number, some positive number is equal to 0. So we got the values of sine 0 degrees, cos 0 degrees, tan 0 degrees. Now very simple, cosine 0 degrees is reciprocal of sine 0, that is 1 upon 0. So 1 upon 0, basically children, if you have a ratio 6 upon 2, we said this is equal to 3. What does it mean? These two should be multiplied by 3 to become 6. Understood? So do we know a number which when multiplied by 0 can produce a product 1? 0 into a number x, that should be equal to 1. Do we know such number? No, we don't know. We do not know any such number. We cannot define it. So this is called as undefined. We can't define that number. Now, sec 0 degrees, it is reciprocal of cos 0 degree, that is 1 upon 1 becomes 1. Next is cot 0 degrees, cot 0 degrees is reciprocal of tan 0 degrees, 1 upon 0, that is again undefined. Got it? So these are the trigonometric ratios for the angle 0 degrees. Sin 0 is 0, cos 0 is 1, tan 0 is 0. So reciprocals, the reciprocals, corresponding reciprocals. Cosec 0 will be 1 upon 0, that is undefined. Sec 0 will be equal to 1. Then tan 0 is equal to 1 upon 0, that is again undefined. Sorry, cot 0 will be equal to 1 upon 0, 1 upon tan, reciprocal of tan, that is again undefined. So these are the trigonometric ratios for 0 degrees. Let's find out the trigonometric ratios for theta equal to 90 degrees. In the same triangle, children, please pay attention. If this theta has to become 90 degrees, subjected to the constraint that the triangle has to be there. So if you say theta has to become 90 degrees, then I can shift this A here. So in that case, your triangle will be lost. You no longer will be having a triangle. So what I have to do is, if I have to make this theta as 90 degrees, see, it is just like I am looking at the top of a building. The closer I move to the building, I have to look higher. So the angle increases. So if this point C comes closer to point B, suppose point C is here now. So this angle increased. Again, if it is here, the angle is increased. So if theta tends to become 90 degrees, if theta has to become 90 degrees, point C has to come closer to point B. Gradually it has to coincide with point B. In that case, what happens? Point C coincides with point B. So length of line segment BC tends to become 0. I am not writing equal to, because it's not equal to. It's point C is approaching point B. As point C approaches point B, theta approaches 90 degrees. Please try to understand, children, the difference between equal to 0 or tends to become 0. So this theta, as point C comes closer and closer to point B, this theta comes closer and closer to 90 degrees. It comes closer and closer. So gradually, as point C coincides with point B, in that particular case, theta will become 90 degrees. So length of BC tends to become 0. Now if point C has coincided here, AC will be equal to AB, because point C is also lying here. So AB will be equal to AC. This is the condition when theta approaches 90 degrees. What is the effect of this in the trigonometric ratios? Let's see. So sine theta, that is sine 90 degrees. Sine is perpendicular upon hypotenuse. AB upon AC. So as theta tends to become 90 degrees, AB will be equal to AC. I can replace AB by AC. AC upon AC equal to 1. Now cos theta, that is cos 90 degrees. Cos is base upon hypotenuse. So BC upon AC. As theta approaches 90, BC, length of BC has to nullify. It approaches 0. 0 upon AC. AC has got some length. This becomes 0. 0 upon any non-zero quantity is always 0. Tan theta, that is tan 90 degrees. Tan is perpendicular upon base. That is AB upon BC. What is happening? AB is there, but BC tends to become 0. AB has got some length. So any non-zero real number divided by 0 will be what? Undefined. Again, cosec 90 degrees is reciprocal of sine 90, becomes 1. Sec 90 degrees, reciprocal of cos 90, that is 1 upon 0, so it will be undefined. Cot 90 degrees, reciprocal of tan 90, what is it? What is tan 90? AB upon 0, this reciprocal, 0 upon AB. 0 upon any non-zero real number is 0. Clear? So these are the values. Sin 90 is 1, cos 90 is 0, tan 90 undefined. They are reciprocals. Cosec 90 is 1, sec 90 is undefined, cot 90 is 0. So these are the values of some specific angles. So the best way to remember all these values is to have them in a tabulated form, and I'll tell you how to memorize it or what will be the easier method. I'll make a table. Zero degrees, 30 degrees, 45 degrees, 60 degrees, 90 degrees. These are the values of theta, the sine theta, cos theta, tan theta, cosec theta, sec theta and cot theta. Just remember the values of sine theta. We have derived sine 0 degrees is 0. In the previous class we discussed sine 30 degrees is 1 by 2. We found sine 45 degrees to be 1 upon under root 2. Sine 60 degrees was under root 3 upon 2. Just now we did sine 90 degrees is 1. If you are able to memorize these values, you can complete this table. For cos, start writing from here. Cos 0 degrees is 1. Cos 30 degrees will be under root 3 upon 2. Next, cos 45 degrees. You are moving in this direction for cos. 1 upon under root 2. Then cos 60 degrees will be 1 upon 2. Cos 90 degrees will be 0. Okay? So you just have to memorize the values of sine. Write all the values of sine in the reverse order, starting from 90 degrees to 0 degrees. For cos theta, 0 to 90 degrees. Now, tan theta is simple sine theta upon cos theta. See, what is sine theta? Perpendicular upon hypotenuse divided by cos theta. What is cos theta? Base upon hypotenuse. Cancel. What are we left with? Perpendicular upon base. Perpendicular upon base is tan theta. Okay, so tan theta is sine theta divided by cos theta. 0 divided by 1, 0. 1 by 2 divided by root 3 by 2, 1 upon root 3. Now 1 upon root 2 divided by 1 upon root 2 is 1. Root 3 upon 2 divided by 1 upon 2 is under root 3. 1 divided by 0 is undefined. Okay, now these are reciprocals. Cosec theta, cosec 0 is reciprocal of sine 0, 1 upon 0, undefined. Reciprocal of 1 upon 2 is 2. Reciprocal of 1 upon under root 2 is under root 2. Reciprocal of under root 3 upon 2 is 2 upon under root 3. Reciprocal of 1 is 1. Now sec theta, reciprocal of cos theta. Reciprocal of 1 is 1. Reciprocal of this is 2 upon under root 3. Reciprocal of this is under root 2. Reciprocal of 1 upon 2 is 2. Reciprocal of 0, 1 upon 0 is undefined. Okay, now cot theta is reciprocal of tan theta. So 1 upon 0, reciprocal of 0, 1 upon 0, undefined. Reciprocal of 1 upon root 3 is root 3. Reciprocal of 1 is 1. Reciprocal of root 3 is 1 upon under root 3. And this will be 0. Just now we have done. Okay, so this is the best way to make the table and memorize them. If you are able to have this in your mind, you can construct the entire table. And children, at any instant, if someone asks you the value of any of these particular angles, you say, what is cosec 60? What is sine 60? What is cot 30? What is tan 60? Whatever it is. If they ask you, you should be able to give the answer spontaneously, instantly. So that should be the level, the way that you memorize them, and they are very useful. So I hope you are solving the questions of NCERT also, right? So these are the topics that we have done. They will cover exercise 8.1 and 8.2. Tomorrow in the next class we shall discuss some questions which are based on these values of NCERT exercise 8.2. Till then children, stay safe, stay healthy. Goodbye. We'll see in the meet in the next class.